social media optimization, social media marketing, and several other stuff. Okay, now I'm going to present my screen with the same document and the window. Okay, and you will be able to see this. Okay, once I immediately see my window is switching from the display, I can see that and I will try to act on it. Okay. Okay, the messages. Okay, so one of the member is requesting, like, if there is any message you are posting, seems like a little bit of diversion, so we can stop these messages. Might it help concentrate and have to save data. Okay, great. I think my screen is visible to you gentlemen, right? Yeah, just now it is initiating. Cool. So I have been talking about the, you know, optimization practices and the marketing practices which I was talking to you. Okay, so I will continue from the marketing topic which I actually, you know, left off. Okay, so basically marketing is promotion. It can include both paid and non-paid, but in digital what it is observed is whenever there is a marketing practice, it involves a financial investment. Okay, whenever there is a marketing practice, it involves a financial investment. And organizations, companies, okay, who are into business categories can afford to invest money and then to brand themselves, increase their visibility in the process. But the digital platform is common for all. Everybody can be a part of it. So there is a technique called organic methods. That is what we have discussed till now. Okay. And marketing is when we generally used to start making, you know, paying money to other people. Okay. Generally one is social media marketing and another one is search engine marketing. Okay. I have given a couple of examples earlier. One is the tomato plant where you grow the plant by yourself in your own home. Okay. By sowing those seeds, sprinkling some water, and to get the output, what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to do some activities on a regular basis. For example, you sow your seed, sprinkle some water every day and expose it to sunlight. These are the best practices you need to follow. And expose it to the requirement and also sprinkle water with a limited requirement. Don't overdo anything. Do it the required amount of activities. Continuously repeat the same thing again and again. When you grow this tomato plant, continuously, you know, actively we have to execute the same things again and again. Sprinkle water, sow it to the sunlight on daily basis, save it and protect it from predators. Basically somebody, okay, a goat or an animal, cow, can come and eat your plant and go away. So protect it. Okay, now so these are the things you need to do it on a consistent basis. Do it continuously for 2 to 3 months. You will see your output coming, the tomatoes coming out, they are ripening, and you can take it, use it to cook your food. Now this kind of vegetable that you take it from the plant is called organic fruit or organic vegetables, organic cultivation. Organic cultivation is something where things happen normally, naturally, without having to support any extra fertilizers or chemicals. The same way, when you tell your content, your information and the product to the public world, in reality with good quality, automatically your content becomes visible based on the quality and people will flock around your product to buy them. That is natural. Okay. Now the natural way of driving visitors to your website is basically called organic traffic. You drive visitors naturally. That is called organic traffic. You drive visitors by paying money. That is paid traffic. Very simple as that. Which is healthy. Organic is healthy. You cultivate your own plant, your own vegetables. You cut it, you eat it, you live healthy. Correct. And moreover, you cultivate once, you reap the benefits, or you reap the benefits again and again. Every time when it is, like, you know, giving you fruits and vegetables again and again. So the same way, okay, search engine is a platform where you go start opening the search engine platform, search anything related to a product, advertisement or services. Automatically what it is going to do, it is going to show you ads. Intentionally I'm going to search some product. Okay, so intentionally I'm going to search some products, and that product is going to give me an advertisement. I guess based on my personal profile, based on my activities, things whichever I do. Okay, what I'm trying to do here is I am trying to see advertisements being shown. Okay, now so we have one more culprit here. Okay, let me resume my presentation. I think I got it. Okay, so if you look at this one, so it automatically, I'm going to search a particular keyword, and I think obviously it will show me the advertisement. Okay, because the choice of words which I'm going to use, okay, is basically into advertisements. Okay, the choice of words which I'm using is basically into advertisements. Okay, let me say pen drive. Okay, 32 GB pen drive, or I can even look for a hard disk. Why does this not open? Okay, let me open a new window. Okay, so 32 GB pen drive. Let me say online. So the intention clearly says this guy is looking for a 32 GB pen drive online. Okay, now the search engine knows, oh, this guy is searching for a pen drive, 32 GB pen drive. Now it says advertisements out there, shopping advertisements. Okay, can you see it is mentioned as ads? See here, ads. Okay, the same way. So pen drive, no advertisements on the organic results. Can you see here, when there is no ad is mentioned, it is organic in nature. When ads is mentioned, this is paid in nature, marketing, paid marketing. Okay, now this particular content is displayed not just because I'm searching as 32 GB pen drive online. When I search 32 GB pen drive online, it shows almost 6 plus 9 products for me. 9 products sold by different people: Tata Click, Radriya.com, Amazon.in, Flipkart, Easy Shopee. Different people are paying to Google to show this advertisement to the customer when he searches about 32 GB or pen drive or online. Now let us look at the personalization concept now. Okay, I as a user have searched 32 GB pen drive online, and Amazon is ranking number 1 organic result, Flipkart is ranking number 2 organic result. Amazon and Flipkart, when I click on this Amazon result and Flipkart result, neither Amazon nor Flipkart spend money, because this is a natural traffic. They have added content in such a way that people likes it, and people also trust that the content is really good, and Google can validate that this information is really good. And out of 83 results which are shown here, Google has decided to put these people on the top, right? Almost showing up these content in the SERP results, organic SERP, is almost selling a product in a retail shop. Okay, so when a customer comes and asks for a product in a retail shop, the shop owner will give a product. Let me say the shop, you know, the person who is actually, you know, buying the product is asking in a generic manner. He raises a generic question of, can you give me a bathing soap? Now the customer, the business owner, what he will do? He will give a bathing soap of his choice of good quality. The same thing happens. I go to Google and ask Google 32 GB pen drive online. The Google says like, oh, based on the previous people's activity and all the stuff, we have decided Amazon and Flipkart are the content where you can go out and explore. So these are the top product. Take it. So Google is telling me, it is helping me. Now what I'm going to do? I went searched for this keyword 32 GB pen drive online. It showed me advertisement. Now I did not choose any ad. I did not click this ad. This ad. I did not click any advertisement. I clicked only on the organic results. Organic results. Now, when I click either Amazon or Flipkart, now for the keyword 32 GB pen drive online, if I click Amazon, now compared to remaining 82 websites, Amazon gets a push. It gets added value because When this guy searched 32GB pen drive online, he selected Amazon. So he did not select other platform. So there is something special with Amazon that attracted Amud Kumar to get into. So that is not available with other platform. So like this, metrics will be built on websites. Okay. Now I searched this one with 32GB pen drive online, and let me say I'm not clicking on any website, which means this user is not interested in exploring more. Now I go ahead and search the same keyword again, 32GB pen drive online. Now look at the advertisement at the top, Reliance Digital, Amazon, Tata Click is at the top three. I reload this keyword, which means I am searching the keyword again. I'm going to a shop owner and asking the shop owner again. Right? Now what happens? When it was showing 9 products in the first slot, okay, now it is showing only 5 products. Okay, initially it used to show 9 products. 3 at the top, another 3 at the top, another 3 at the bottom. 9 product. When the user searches the same keyword again, it shows only 5 product. Reason because when the user searches the same keyword initially, he did not express interest neither on the organic result or on the paid result. Now when I search again, now Google understands, okay, this user is not willing to explore more. Okay, now why should I have to show the paid content to him? Maybe he's not interested. So the number of content shown is little less. Okay, I searched 2 times. Now let me search it the 3rd time. I'm searching the same keyword again on the 3rd time. Now what happens? Google has reduced another 2 more advertisement. From 9, it became 5. From 5, it became 3. Because I neither chose the organic result, I neither chose the, nor chose the paid results. Okay, now the 3rd time when I go out and search the same keyword, potentially Google may not even show me the advertisement because like, hey, this guy is like making fun here. He is not interested in buying anything and he is simply searching. Okay, now what Google will decide? Okay, let me not show him advertisement because he is not interested. Correct? Let me not show him advertisement because he is not interested. I don't know why it's getting delayed. It's taking more time. Okay. So when I try to search this one again, the same keyword, okay, so Google potentially it may show or may not show. Okay, so I have never chosen anything, so Google is unable to understand why the hell I'm searching this 32GB pen drive online. Why am I searching this? Google cannot understand. Okay, anyway, so I did not click on anything, so I am not showing interest to anybody. Okay, if 32GB pen drive online is the keyword that is used by thousands and thousands of people, and all those people come and visit Amazon and Flipkart again and again, again and again. Now it is very difficult to beat Amazon and Flipkart and bring our website at the top. Okay, that's basically user behavior. So at end of the day, the search engine spiders are designed both paid and organic methods to deliver what people need. Correct? Now, cultivating your own tomatoes and buying it, I mean harvesting it, is called organic method. It takes time. It takes time investment. It takes effort. It's a combination of those organic results. Okay. Marketing is something where you go to your nearby shop. You go to your nearby shop, buy 1/2 kg of tomato and pay 10 rupees of charge. Pay 10 rupees, take 1/2 kg of tomato. What does this mean? We can relate this practice to the marketing practice that we are doing out here. You are getting a point? Okay. You can relate this practice to the marketing practice. Okay. Let me say I run a smartphone manufacturing company. Let me say I am Sony. Okay. Now, when people come and search, Puruga is selling the mobile. Okay. Chennai Mobile is selling the mobile. Okay. No, there are different retail outlets who is selling my product. Let me say I am Sony. And as a manufacturer, I do sell my products. Okay. So when people search online, everybody, when they search, let me say different websites are coming at the top. As a business owner, what will I do? I will run an advertisement campaign to show to people about my products or services. So when people search a particular keyword or something, an advertisement is shown at the top. Now, this helps my business to get more visibility. Okay. Now, you you invest your time, you invest your knowledge and create content around your website, product or services, drive visitors to your website, they start connecting with you. That is how the business happens. Marketing is something where you go online, pay money to either Facebook or Google, and they will show your advertisement to other people. Okay, your target audience. Now, in simple terms, if you are a single person, single means like I'm not talking about the marital status. If you are a one-man show, right, and you are planning to generate income source through digital platforms and other stuff, okay, it is a great practice to get into organic methods rather than going for paid methods, because organic is like it consumes time and knowledge, not money. So you are safer on the financial background. Number one. Number two, you can wait until you get your results and you start generating your revenue. Number two. Okay. But if you are a business, you need to make sure that you have to invest money. Okay. For immediate result, go for marketing practices on search engine and social media. Okay. For long term recurring results, go for organic practices and methods. Okay. That's one. Gentlemen, if you are asking a doubt, you can raise your mute. Otherwise, it is really appreciated to put yourself on mute. I appreciate that. Okay. Right. So you can be on mute if you are talking off topic. Okay, you can be on mute. Okay, it's really going to help us support a lot. Okay, now the difference between I'm going to show you some and we are getting into a search engine optimization topic. Okay, I just want to show you traditional and digital marketing. Obviously, we know a lot. We know a lot because we have to go through and see to it. Okay, what are the challenges? You know, people generally say, only when you go into the hot sun, you will understand the value of a shadow, right? You will understand the value of a shadow only when you get into a hot sun, right? The same way, what are the traditional marketing practices we have? Okay, only when we know what we do in the traditional marketing practices, we can understand how beneficial it is in the digital platform. Okay, so traditional marketing is something where we follow it on a hereditary basis, which means like my father did the business, myself do a business, okay, I do some activity. Basically, so these are all the few things which I do it on a traditional basis, right? Now, especially outdoor advertisements where we show your advertisement to other people, billboard. Okay, billboard is something where we have a static advertisement being created. You would have seen these in your railway station, bus stand. Okay, you can see in the when you go into a national highways, you can see on the left and right side a huge banner which is standing out there, which basically we call it as billboards. Okay, and we have a traditional method of advertising on buses and taxis. You can see behind the autos. Okay, bus has the rectangle shaped advertisement products like ATG, Chennai Sales. Okay, these brands advertise their products using the bus or in a taxi advertisement. Wall poster. Okay. Gentlemen. Mr. Rajapandian, can you please check out your ID? You can please put yourself on mute. I really appreciate that. Okay. Organizer who has an admin right, can you please mute this person? Anybody who is a part of the organizing team, if you see some irrelevant sound coming, you can voluntarily go ahead and mute the individual. We have an option, okay, because I don't have an option from my side. Okay, that will really help the complete crowd to be benefited. Okay, Mr. Rajapandian, if you are actually listening to us, you can please pay attention. You can mute yourself. I appreciate it. Okay, cool. Anybody from the organizing team, please check out Mr. Rajapandian's profile and put him on mute. I appreciate that. Okay. 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 Okay, just gentlemen, please be online. Just give me a couple of seconds. I'll be back. Normal. I need somebody to manage. See, there is lots of external sound coming. Raja Pandian சொல்லிட்டு ஒரு ப்ரொஃபைல் அவர் கவனிக்கவே மாட்டேங்கிறாரு, ஆனா மியூட் மட்டும் ரிலீஸ் பண்ணிருக்காரு. எனக்கு என்னன்னா, யாராச்சும் அட்மின் லெவல் இருக்கிறவங்க லாகின் பண்ணீங்கன்னா யூ கேன் கோ
some noise is coming sir,
that's what I'm trying to introduce the recommend the person, but he is not attentive, that's the problem. Mr. Rajapandian, can you please mute yourself? We really appreciate that. We have 200 plus profiles out there. Thank you so much, amazing, it is done. I'm happy, thank you. Right, thanks for your understanding, gentlemen. Okay, so let me get back to the point again. Okay, so the advertisements of broadcasting, okay, showing our advertisement to other people on different means of traditional practices. Okay. Cool. So, telemarketing, calling people, talking to them. So these are all the traditional marketing techniques we have. Okay, and I have given the example of one after another, we can see. Okay, so this is one example of your billboard advertisement. Okay, where we show this advertisement to other people. Okay, in the huge window. Okay, so this is like your outdoors advertisement, basically billboard advertisement, which looks very bigger. Okay, especially you can see this while traveling on the national highways, or in the railway stations, or in the metropolitan cities where you bypass, travel over a bypass. Okay, now another one is like bus or taxi advertisement, traditional practices we have. Okay, and wall posters. Okay, wall posters. Okay, and broadcasting the information on TV and other stuff, print media, especially newspapers. Okay, weekly newspapers. Okay, daily newspapers, magazines, materials. Okay, so this is basically, and sending out a mail, we call it a snail mail. Okay, snail mail, which is like a postal card, inland letter, okay, catalogs. Okay, we distribute those things. So these are all the traditional practices we have: telecalling, calling to people, okay, talking to them over a phone, and now closing the deal. Okay, so basically telecalling. Okay, so these are all the traditional methods we have. And one more is like, you know, outdoor, you know, not outdoor, okay, window advertisement. Okay, so which basically looks like this. So when you cross a road, you can see these advertisements being shown inside a closed window or a mirror, a glass. Okay, now so these are the traditional advertisement types we have. But what is the problem with the traditional marketing is like it consumes more time and all the stuff, time, money. Okay, we will discuss about that one little later. Okay, now again coming back with the same topic which we discussed earlier. Okay, what is digital marketing? So process of promoting product or services in digital, I think we have seen in depth about what is digital marketing platforms like SEO, SEM, SMO, SMM. Okay, so we use social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube to show advertisement to other people. You can see when you scroll your Facebook, story, when you scroll down your Instagram, YouTube videos and all, you end up seeing advertisements coming in between. It's working that way. Such ways. Okay, so using your social media platforms, you can show advertisement to people. You can drive visitors or advertise yourself using a website. You have your own website, you can advertise yourself. Okay, when you go out and search this branded search, okay, when you go Amazon business marketing training, you go online, you end up seeing my local business listing coming in, and also you see my website coming at the top. You can see my website is being shown to people. Now this is how, when people know about me, my training schedules and other stuff, when they want to learn from me, they search with my name, brand name of Amadu Kumar, and they come to me. I do have an institute where people come and connect with us. Okay, that is entirely different story. Okay, now what happens is like, this is how I connect with people. Now what is my responsibility is to increase the brand value of this particular person, Amadu Kumar, so that when people search Amadu Kumar, it shows my content to other people. Okay, this is one. So the same way local business listing is shown up. This is how people connect with me. They explore my content. They come to my website. What I do? I take the advantage of search engine optimization practices to rank for this keyword at the top. Now when people search, they come to my website for free. They click and come to my website for free. This type of traffic is called organic traffic. Okay. They have come to my website for free. Now they have landed. What do I do? After 5 seconds of this person coming to my website, I show them a full pop-up window covering, hey, are you interested to learn digital marketing? I can train you. You give a call to my number or click here to apply for my course. Right. Now people come for free to my website. They look at the website and I understand them. And after 5 seconds, I have designed a website in such a way to put a complete cover notification where if people they do not want the course, they can close it or they can give a call to my number or they can click on this button to apply for my course. Now once they close it, they can explore my content. In the exploring the content, I have added a contact number. In the process, I have told people what actually happens in reality, and also I have an option to offer chat option with people. People can come, they can chat with me. Now I have 2 to 3 CTAs. We call it a CTA, call to action. I show a website. Once people come, read the content. Once they go away from here, what are they supposed to do? What if 1,000 people come, all the 1,000 people go away? What happens? Right? I don't get a business. No, I need to learn the art of driving targeted traffic to my website. Only when people look for a digital marketing course or search engine optimization course or whatever it may be, I should show my website in different platforms like YouTube, Quora, Google, Facebook and other platforms, and they drive visitors to my website. And I have designed the website to show information for people to connect with me. So when people come connect with me, that is how a visitor becomes a customer. When a visitor, when somebody comes to a website, he is called a visitor. When he goes from this visitor to another place, that is called a customer. When he meets the requirement, so that is basically called the process of a visitor becoming a customer is called conversion. A person gets converted from a visitor to a customer. Customer is someone who takes my service or they buy my product. Visitor is someone who comes to my website for the first time, or they have never done business with me. So the process of converting a visitor into a customer is called a conversion. Now, when I meet my goal of converting people, I call it as a conversion ratio. And I optimize my page to increase my conversions by adding sufficient keywords, by adding the contact details, and also giving people to register and also call to me. And people should find it easy to connect with me. They can explore my contact number, they can see my chat option, and they can connect with me. And that is how I deal with business in the next stage. This is applicable for any business you take. In any business you take, no technical knowledge required. Okay, no technical knowledge required. Okay, cool. So when you look into this one, so this is how we do SEO, search engine optimization practices. We write content related to the keywords that people are searching. We raise visibility. Okay. Now, so once we have a look at it, we can have a website to drive traffic and convert that traffic into revenue. Okay. The third practice is the content marketing. Okay. We can promote the content. Okay. You can promote the content. You create a content and you promote it. You create a content. We are manufacturers. I have a website and I create a content, and I, after creating the content, I promote it into different platforms, especially social media. Okay, I send it to my email address database. I can set it up. Gentlemen, somebody near Parvez, please, can you please mute yourself? Mir Parvez, Mir Parvez, ID to mute yourself. Mir Parvez, I'm calling out to mute yourself.
I have already muted, sir.
I think there are 2 people. No, your ID, it seems your kid is taking a session for me. Can you help me out?
mere pervase is there, but which is it is muted, sir.
No, then how can I can hear you, gentlemen? Your video is muted, sir, but your audio is not muted.
Both audio and video is muted, sir.
Video is muted, but audio you are supposed to mute, na? Disconnected. Okay. Anyway, so this is one such way of driving visitors to a website. Okay. Then we can also have a content being marketed. Okay. Content marketing is about you create a text content, image content, video content. When we say content, it is not restricted ourselves only to text, because I heard from one of the students in the early days of training that because I said content, they took only text content. They never thought about image and video. Okay, content is a combination of text, image, and video. Okay, now so creating content about a product or a service, it can be advertorial content, it can be editorial content, a product review content, and promoting the content is so-called content marketing. You market your content. You tell other people. You might have seen in Facebook profile, people will generally take the content and they will put it into their groups. They put it in their stories. They put it to their WhatsApp status. They, you know, all the stuff. Okay. So this is basically a content marketing strategy which is there with the digital platform, where you plan what kind of content to create and create a strategy around it. After creating the plan, you produce the content using a content writer. Okay. And once the content is created, promote it across using social media platforms and any other paid and organic methods. Once the content is promoted, analyze how it is performing very well and what are the other opportunities that we can increase the visibility of the content. So this is basically marketing a content. Content marketing is part of SEO, search engine optimization practices. Okay. And we have one more marketing technique in digital platform called affiliate marketing, which is basically affiliate means associating with existing business models. Okay. Brands like Amazon and Flipkart, they have existing affiliate marketing practices. Okay. You can promote, you can push those products. Okay. This is about affiliate marketing. Okay. For example, as a business owner, I can go to Amazon and tell Google, tell Amazon that, hey, Amazon, you know what? I have this many products and can you sell my products? Okay, then Amazon says, yeah, I have a very good brand visibility. I can sell you the products on behalf of my brand name, and you have to give me 40%, 60% share which you're making in the revenue. Okay, now the person says, okay, without me building my own brand, your brand is giving me a business. I can give you 60% of the total revenue. I can take the 40% of the money. And that's how it happens. We associate with other people. And we can also make money through affiliate marketing, which means like you go join with Amazon or Flipkart or any other affiliate programs online. Go click, submit your personal details and website, and it will be approved. It is 100% free. And once you retail a product from either Amazon, Flipkart, or any other platform, they are going to pay you a commission ranging from 2% to 12%. Okay, 2 to 12 max. Now, you take this advantage, you can generate a revenue also. As a business owner, you can pay commission to people when a product is sold. As a blogger or a content creator, we can get revenue when a product is sold using our website or the content. Okay. Now the next technique which we have is basically called inbound marketing in general. Okay. See, this you have to understand very seriously. Okay. Inbound marketing. Inbound marketing is more effective than the outbound marketing practices. Okay. Inbound marketing is something where people find your value and they will come in search of you. For example, when somebody searches about a content in internet, in YouTube, Google, Quora, somewhere, they explore your information. You don't need to go and tell them, hey, come to my website. They will explore your website. Once they like your content, the quality which is inside, they will connect with you voluntarily. Okay, they will connect with you on a voluntary basis and the business will happen. When a person comes to us voluntarily, the business conversion will be very high because of the inbound nature. People are coming in search of us. Okay. Outbound marketing is something. There is another marketing method called outbound marketing, which means like you reach out to people. Like we receive personal phone calls, right? Somebody who gives a call suddenly asking like, Amazon, are you looking for a personal loan? I can give you up to 5 lakh rupees. Right? Now I can say like, no, I'm not interested. So the probability of conversion ratio is very low in outbound marketing. You reach out to people, the number game starts. The 80-20 rule is applicable. When you reach 100 people, 80 people will reject you, 20 people will say yes. Right? So this is what happens with outbound marketing. When you reach people, the probability of conversion is very less. But when people come in search of you, the probability of conversion is very more, or it's very high. Right? So there are different methods. Okay, cross marketing, which means like take a content, put it into Facebook, take the same content, put it into YouTube, and in YouTube promote Facebook, in Facebook promote YouTube, in Quora promote your website, from Quora from your website you can promote your YouTube channel. Okay, so cross promotion with each other, that is one thing. Be active on social media platform, create more content. Okay, landing pages. Okay, landing pages is something where you land after clicking on a link. Okay, any page can be called as a landing page. Okay, do SEO. Okay, analyze your content, promote your content, marketing, automate your things. Okay, so this is one such technology which is basically called inbound marketing, which means like you make people to come in search of you. For example, in your home, I generally give this example to lots of people because they like it. Okay, in your home, if you want to see a group of ants coming to a particular place, you want to see, or you suddenly want to, you know, get a photograph of an ant which is like moving from one place to another. There are two ways of doing it. Number one, you can figure out where these ants are coming from. You can track, you can go to a place and see. And the erumbu kuthu enga irukku paakkalam illaya, that ants where they are living. That's one opportunity. This is like outbound marketing. You go in search of your audience. Now, another smartest technique is to sprinkle some sweet water, some sugar, or some snacks. Now, after 5 minutes or so, you start seeing those ants coming in a huge number of, you know, quantity, and they start eating the stuff. Okay, so this is the second one where we can have. Okay, so it works such a way that inbound marketing is like you sprinkle some sweet and sugar and they come in search of you. You tell the internet that, hey, I'm offering digital marketing course, I'm training people on this one, I'm a speaker, I'm a, you know, consultant, I'm a strategist, right? So you tell this one to the people. Now when people come to know that, oh, there's a guy like this, okay, then they want to associate with me, they want to have the event being organized, and it is being done. Now, inbound marketing, I spread my fragrance of digital marketing trainer, right? When people can smell, he is a digital marketing trainer, they want to come with me, right? So the same way is your business, whatever it may be. Let me say you own a flower shop. Make sure that your flowers of smell goes around 2 kilometers around. So whomsoever is within this 2 kilometers radius, they will come to know like, oh, there is a flower shop nearby. They will come in search of you, correct? So catching people's attention, okay, that is one method of doing it. And email marketing. Okay, so marketing your content through email platform, this is another marketing technique we have. Okay, one of the simplest, easiest method of doing it. Okay, and search engine marketing, paying money to search engine platforms like Google, Yahoo, Bing, DuckDuckGo, Yandex. Okay, so this is basically a search engine marketing based content. Okay, so another promotion is search engine marketing. Okay, now this is a small image that explains how does this work. We create a content. Okay, when people come search of the content, our website is ranked there. Okay, and it is shown in internet. Now we can also promote, we can target people specifically, and when people click on the link, they will land on your content like that. So marketing your content on search engine. So search engine marketing will help us to show my advertisement to people who are looking for using a keyword. Okay, and also, right, looking for the information using the keyword and the services which they can take it from us. Okay, so it's basically search engine marketing, but this is done with paid practice. So these are all the platform we have. We can pay, you can do organic methods. Okay, in organic methods we have email marketing, we have search engine optimization marketing. Okay, and promotion. Yes, gentlemen, my screen is presented. I think I have some issues. Okay, now let me, you know, just take you through the small differences between that. Basically, traditional marketing is costly. You could have experienced that. Okay, traditional marketing is costly. Okay, you will be paying for it. Okay, digital marketing is affordable. I can't say cheap, I can say it is affordable. How much it is affordable? I can run a campaign in Facebook for just 40 rupees a day. 40 rupees. I spend 40 rupees a day to promote my brand. to promote my link, to make visitors to come to my website at 40 rupees per day. Okay, how much result you will get by promoting it for 40 rupees per day? I'm sure it is nil or very minimal result. But what I'm trying to say is, like, when I go to a media based advertisement, correct, television based advertisements and all, in peak hour they charge 8000 rupees per second per display. 8 second. Now 10 second advertisement is worth 80,000 rupees. Now in the peak hour of running a very interesting serial, the money that we spend to show my advertisement to the public people who are broad or mass advertisement platform is almost 80,000 rupees per telecast. Every second they put an advertisement, 80,000 rupees. When they put another advertisement, it's gone. It depends. Now it's not only 80,000 rupees, it can be of any value. A 5 second advertisement can cost 40,000 rupees for you, right? The same way. But the thing is, like, it's costly. A normal common man, a one-man show product, or a small startup companies cannot afford to go to television based advertisement like this. I have to look into this. But getting into Google or digital marketing, Facebook platform, I can start my campaign, start running it for 40 rupees every day. I invest 40, I generate 1 or 2 leads, I generate 25,000 to 30,000 revenue. Then out of my 20,000 rupees revenue, I invest 10%, 2,500. Then I increase my budget to 2,500. Then I run advertisement campaign, I generate revenue. Once I make 1 lakh rupees, I invest 10,000 rupees. Once I make 2 lakh rupees, I invest 20,000 rupees. Now I can gradually increase. I have an opportunity to establish myself in digital platform. But whereas in traditional, if you don't have money, you cannot advertise. You need huge money to reach huge people. Okay. In traditional marketing, it cannot be targeted. Okay. We cannot target people on the traditional marketing platform. Okay. At the max, what we can do? You can publish a news content or an article. Okay. You can publish a news content or an article. Okay. On your particular newspaper, but targeting areas. Let me say, Adyar.
Share your share, sir.
Yeah, screen is coming now. Yeah. Mr. Venkatesan D has presented his screen. Appreciate it. Okay. I think you get my screen. You got it. Okay. Now what happens? I can target a location. For example, I can run an advertisement across Coimbatore, across Chennai, or I can go to a newspaper agency and they have a local newspapers like Adyar Times or Chennai Times or Coimbatore Times, something like that. So I can give a mass advertisement. I don't have control over who will see my ads, but in digital, it's not like that. Okay. I can tell Google and Facebook that, hey, you know what? People who are interested in search engine optimization only show my advertisement. Do you get my point? People who are interested in search engine optimization topic only show my advertisement. And across Chennai show my advertisement. But don't show advertisement on Thirunmur. We can eliminate. Okay, we target Coimbatore. We can target advertisement across Coimbatore platform. And let us make sure that we don't target people who are in those places of Singanallur. Right? We can eliminate. Okay, Cyber Bakalani, we can eliminate. Okay, but in news media or press media or digital, traditional media platforms, there will be advertisement for a 5 lakh rupees worth car. Somebody who is eating donda and bhaji, tea, vada, with the paper advertisement on it. Right? Now, what kind of targeting this happens? Okay, so it's very difficult to have a specific targeting being done. Once your advertisement goes live, post the completion of the advertisement window or period, you cannot measure how many people came to your advertisement, through which source they came to your website, or through which source they came to your location. You cannot track until otherwise you give them a form and ask them to fill, how did you know us? Right? They can tick, oh, I know you through internet, I know you through my friend referred me. We can only track, but whereas in digital, you can track from which source did people come. Did they come from your social media profile? In social media, did they come through organic search, or did they come through paid marketing? in search engine, did people come by searching your website keyword or they came to your website directly? So we have different sources of visitors in digital platform. One source of visitor which everybody has is brand visitors. When people search a brand keyword, they search, they come to the website. Okay, and we have organic results where people search you a service related queries and they come to your website. We have affiliate visitors where we can associate with other people to retail our product, and other business people will sell our product in their website, due to which people will explore my content. Affiliate visitors. Referral visitor. People going and reading a content in Quora.com, and in Quora.com, Amit Kumar is going and giving an answer to other people. Now, Quora.com is giving reference to AmitKumar.com or YouTube.com. Now, that is basically called referral visitors. Okay, we have search network visitors. We run advertisement campaigns to drive visitors to the website. Search network visitors. We have display visitors, which means like we run display and image advertisements to drive visitors. Okay, so these are the different methods we have. So we cannot measure the source in which visitors came through traditional, but in digital we can measure it. Okay, obviously traditional advertisements are permanent. That is the advantage. Okay, I can put an advertisement somewhere on for 6 months contract. So when people go by this way every time, they can see the advertisement going, coming, going, coming, going, coming. But in digital, it is not so. When somebody is scrolling a Facebook their story, suddenly advertisement comes, and the story ends after 5 seconds. Also, now this guy, if he is interested, he will apply. Else, he will go off. Okay. So traditional is permanent in nature, but digital is less permanent, which means like it disappears very easily. Okay. Obviously, traditional marketing consumes time, but traditional marketing consumes time, and digital, it helps you save your time. Okay, the website which I have shown you, whichever the website which I have shown you, is AmitKumar.com. Okay, it is created by me without any technical knowledge, without dependent on a technical developer or anybody else. I created this website by my own. Okay, by spending some money. Okay, so something like that. Okay. There are some systems and techniques where we have where we can create a website. Okay, there will be a separate team, you know, who will be handling teaching about, you know, creating a website related stuff. Okay, I'm still presenting. Okay, okay, so it needs more human resource, but whereas digital doesn't need more. Okay, we can create. Once you edit a content, you can easily modify it. Okay, there is a lots of, you know, value addition with that. Okay, the difference between traditional and digital marketing is what we have seen till now. Okay, now, so I'm not going to get into the creation of a website because we have a separate module which talks about, you know, website creation. I think Mr. Nirmal will, you know, handle it. If required, I'll be coming back to the topic of, you know, creating a website and other stuff. Okay, now I'm coming directly to the search engine optimization topic. Okay, search engine optimization. How do we optimize our content? How do we make our website very friendly with, you know, search engines like Google, Yahoo, Bing, and other stuff? Okay, so the complete SEO activities starts with a keyword. Okay, it starts with a keyword. There are several tools, several content available with respect to keywords and other stuff. Okay. Once we start discussing about tools, there is going to be a huge number of stuff. Okay, once we are going to start discussing about the tools, there's going to be a huge number of stuff, and there is not a single tool. There is always hundreds and hundreds of tools available for everything. Okay, now in order to understand what people are looking for, okay, we call it as a keyword research process. Okay, let me see, is there, I can touch upon that one slightly. Okay, so keyword research process. Okay, and creating a content strategy for a website. Okay, so a keyword research process. I will tell you the simplest keyword research process. Okay, keyword research, which means like we create a content around a particular topic or thing. Okay, so as I've already said, creating a content for a website is a search engine optimization practice, and you have to create the content with a high quality information. You cannot just create it for namesake. Okay, so maximum what happens? You take a website, that website should be related to a particular industry. For example, okay, let me give you a small introduction about a website. Okay, website is basically, not basically, no, Website is nothing but a digital store. Okay, a digital store. Okay, website is nothing but a digital store. You go to a shop. Okay, I can raise this question and people can give me an answer. You go to a shop, and in the shop you can see Vicks, Band-Aid, antiseptic cleaning materials. You are finding mask, and they are giving you some medicines also. What shop is this? Can anybody say what shop is this?
Medical shop.
Medical shop. Wonderful. You go to another shop where they sell all varieties of rice. Correct. Then that the sauce is the rice shop. And in another shop you go, they have masala, they have, you know, like rice, they have, you know, biscuits, all the stuff. That's the grocery.
Supermarket. Right. Supermarket. Now, supermarket.
Supermarket. Now that is out of bound area. Okay. Okay. So now what happens is, like, every store has got a theme. Right. Every store has got a theme. Okay. What theme? You go look at the shop. You will identify easily. You will get this product here or not. Correct. Can you go to a Apollo pharmacy and buy a half a kg of sugar? Can anybody give me an answer? Right. Can I go to a Apollo pharmacy and buy a half a kg of sugar? No.
No. No. You can't listen.
Because that is a medical shop. On what you will get there in the medical shop? You will get medicines. Correct? You will get medicines. Right? At the same way, you go to another shop, go to a rice shop where they sell rice, and you can't afford to buy, you know, let me say, a pair of shoes or, you know, my jeans or t-shirts. No, you cannot. Now, every shop has a theme. You are getting a point? Every shop has a theme, and there is no difference between a traditional store and an online store. Okay, I'm going to tell you, there is a website called Practo. I'm not sure how many of you heard about that. Practo. Practo is regarding what? Practo is regarding what? It is association of doctors. There is a website called Swiggy, Zomato, Foodpanda. Association of food related organizations and restaurants, right? There is a website called Redbus, exclusively for booking tickets. There is a website called Tickets New, which is exclusively for booking tickets, right? Exclusively for booking tickets. Okay, the same way we have to brand our business in such a way. So what we need to do, I take my website, I talk about digital marketing, and my content should talk anything and everything related to digital marketing. SEO, SEM, email marketing, affiliate marketing in Chennai, Madurai, Coimbatore, Theni, because I am established online. I can even offer digital marketing training in Singapore. I can offer it in Malaysia, sitting down at the remote village called Kodangipatti near Bodinayakanur. Can be done. That is the potential of it. International establishment. Now, you have a website, and this website should contain information about all the products you are dealing with. Okay? Wikipedia of everything. You take an industry, okay? You take an industry, automatically it becomes the Wikipedia of the whole content. Your website should be the Wikipedia of the whole content. Okay, so this is what is expected. Now, what I have seen here, I have shown you tablet and medicines. Okay, it is a medical shop. People sell fruits and vegetables. That is basically a vegetable shop, right? Okay, varieties of rice, rice mandi or rice shop, light bulb, electrical item. That is an electrical shop. The same thing, same thing. When you buy products related to online and e-commerce, that is called e-commerce based website. You buy products online. Okay, you associate with a group of doctors and their products and reviews. Now that brand is Practo. Now they are called into medicinal industry. Food or restaurant into Zomato. Bus ticket booking is Redbus. The same thing. Okay, now what do I do? Let me say I am a tailor. I actually tailor dresses, right? So let me say I am a tailor. I am a gents tailor. Now what I want to say, I create a website where it is going to talk about tailoring, especially gents tailoring. Now what is the use of me discussing about the women's product here? What is the use of me discussing about how can I stitch a blouse, how can I stitch a skirt, in skirt, sari, all the stuff? I am a gents trailer, men's trailer. My website should contain information about anything about men's designs. Short shirt, slim fit, right? Large size, extra large size, expandable, flexible pants, like whatever you call it as. Anything related to men's product or t-shirts is what I should have. This is what a website should be. It should be. Okay. This is how it should be. Okay. Now, once you have a website with a sufficient content inside, once you have a website with a sufficient amount of content inside, now people can explore your content more. People can explore your content more. I tell you with a simple example that can help you a lot. Okay. I'm going to tell you a small command which a lot of people are not going to understand about it. Don't think about the technical part of it, because we are not going in depth detail about it. I can help you to go in depth detail about it. That is a different factor. Okay. Now, let me say I'm going to Google. So Google is a website which contains the database of millions, millions of websites. Okay. Does Google has my website inside? In order to check that, I can use operator called site colon operator. Okay. You can check this one for any website. Okay. You just put site colon and type your website, anudakumar.com, and you hit enter. Okay. Site colon and hit enter. Now it says there are 17 results in the page only from anudakumar.com. Nothing from, not from any other website. Inside Google, the website anudakumar.com is having only 17 pages. Okay. Let it be like as it is. Now, let me go to a website of travels. Let me pick up a local travels. Okay. Travels near me. Okay. Somebody who is offering, you know, Tirupati package, you know, Kerala package. Okay. There is something. Okay. Let us take a company. Okay. Which has a website. SNK Tours and Travels. Okay. There is a website called SNK Tours and Travels. I'm clicking on it through Google local business listing. This website loads SNKTours.com. Okay. And they have information about their business or services. They have Kerala tour, okay, Kerala tour for 7,000, okay, Yerka tour packages, Karnataka tour packages, North India tour packages. Okay, now they have more information. Now, what I'm trying to understand is they are offering tour packages, correct? Right, what I'm trying to say is South Indian tour packages, Indian tour package. Let me try to search. South Indian tours, let me try packages. Okay. Now there are other people who will be coming, yatra.com. Okay, yatra.com, which means yatra.com is offering South Indian tour. Now tell me, is the yatra.com and this SNK Travels, are they competitors or not? Text message, please. Are they competitors or not? Right, is yatra.com and SNK Tours and Travels, are they in the same industry? Are they competitors?
Yes, yes. But yes.
Hello,
yeah. Yes,
sir. They are yes,
okay, so they are competitors. Thank you so much. Okay, so they are competitors. Now, what happens is, how come when South India Tours is searched, this SNK Travels is not coming? Right, Make My Trip, Kerala Trip, Tours and Ada, something. Okay, South Tourism, Tourism of India, Travel Dunia, these websites are coming. Why not SNK Tours not coming?
They have not gone on. They have not gone digital. They are just like operating locally, and they have not taken the efforts to like put it online out. So that may be one of the reasons.
Which means they either did not do it or they don't know how to do it. Correct? Number two,
yeah, right. Yeah.
They have got a wonderful designed website, to be very frank. Can you see? Right? They have got a wonderful design. What I'm trying to say is they are also offering the tour packages. I'm going to see how many pages are indexed inside Google from snktours.com. snktours.com has got 54 results inside Google. You are getting my point? snktours.com has got 54 results inside Google. But whereas yatra.com, let me check it out. Okay. Let me check how many articles does yatra.com has got site colon operator. When I put inside, yatra.com has got almost 352 lakh pages indexed inside Google. You are getting a point, right? SNK 2S has got only 54 pages indexed inside. Yatra.com has got 352 lakhs of results indexed inside Google. If you want, you can check it out. Only the result is only from Yatra.com, nothing from else. Correct? The result is only from Yatra.com. No other websites. Can you see here? Right? 158 pages in this particular page alone. Okay, you can see at the top how much it is showing. Right? So it shows only from Yatra.com. Now Yatra.com has got 352 lakh pages, but whereas SNK Travels has got only 54 pages. Now the deal is, why does Yatra.com make my trip, okay, book my, I mean like travel related, you know, services are coming at the top for everything when you search? Because they have millions and millions of inventory. You're getting my point? If I tell you this example, you will understand. SNK Travels is like a petty shop where they have a small shop. They have 54 inventory, 54 products to be sold indirectly. 54 inventory. Because they have 54 inventory, they have 2 to 3 people coming to the shop. Petty shop. A small petty shop. Right? This website, Yatra.com, is like Saravana stores. You go in the 9th floors, whichever they have, you buy anything from the cheapest price to the costliest product. You buy anything. Now, the reason why people in Saravana stores are flocking around is because the inventory is more. They are huge. But whereas small petty shop owners, they have very less. Very less. Now, the deal is, now if Yatra is the, you know, competitor, right? Now, what are the packages you are offering? You are offering Kerala tour packages. Now, check how Yatra.com has written content related to Kerala tour packages. Compare with them. Create your content in such a way. Very simple. Okay, cool. So, each and every article inside a website is like inventory of your business. Every article should drive visitors coming to your website. Am I getting my point? Okay. Now, what to do? You have to write content related to your products. Okay, in order to write content, what we need to do, we should understand what people are looking for. Okay, we should understand what people are looking for. How do we understand what people are looking for? Again, go to Google. There is a feature called Google's auto suggest. Okay, Google auto suggest. Very simple as that. Okay, I go here, I go to my google.com and I search for Kerala tour. Okay, and once I started typing Kerala tour package, you can see Google is trying to predict what I'm saying. You're getting a point, right? Google is trying to predict what I'm trying to say. Because how does Google predict this? Because when people search about Google tour PAC, they have always searched about Kerala tour package from Chennai, Kerala tour package from Madurai, tour packages for family, for couple. Now, if I am offering Kerala tour package, I should have content inside my website which talks about Kerala tour package from Chennai, Kerala tour package from Madurai, from upper somebody who is sitting in Madurai looking for Kerala tour package using the same keyword, they should end up visiting my website. They should end up visiting my website. I can do a research like this. I can also add more keywords. Kerala tour package from Chennai. I can click like this with rates. I can write a separate article which talks about the price, rates and everything by writing about the Kerala tour packages and other stuff. Okay, using a flight. Now, Kerala tour packages from Chennai, honeymoon, very specific. Let me say I write an article about Kerala tour packages from Chennai and I leave it. Now, if I don't have an article related to Kerala tour packages from Chennai honeymoon, I won't get visitors who are traveling for honeymoon. This reason because I don't have honeymoon as a content in my website. So I cannot be shown to people. In Tamil, they used to say, right, Sakti Lirindadana Akapela Varo, which means like Only when you have a content inside the vessel, you can bring it out of your spoon or the current, if you call it as, right? Now, if the content is not inside your website, how come Google can take it up and show up to other people? You're getting a point? Right? That's immaterial. Okay? So the same way, so simple deal is, keep the content available inside your website, whatever the people are searching. Use auto-suggest tool like Google auto-suggest to understand by feeding you a keyword and understanding what kind of keywords are coming up. You are getting a point? Okay, so understanding this one is one such option. So there is a lot of websites coming in. Okay, Google is following 200 plus ranking signals to understand and rank a website at the top. Now, we have lots of professors here. You know, we have lots of people who are in the teaching industry. Okay, and I would like to highlight one thing. If you are having a plan to, establish your business in internet and digital platform, what you are supposed to do is hire somebody who can write content, content writer. Hire somebody who can write content related to your products or services, and simply write content and enrich your website with content. Right? Enrich your website with content. Enrich it with content. You see how many content Wikipedia has, you know how much content that does, you know, Amazon has, you know how much content does your competitor has. If you look into it, the one strategy that you can take it from tomorrow for your business is like, start creating content for your website. Simple one solution, simple solution. Never ever mess up with other stuff. Simply create content. Simply, nothing else. Keep creating content. Content should be unique. It should be quality content. It should be informative to people. People should feel like, people should have a feel of Shankar's movie after watching it. Wow. Right? You know, there is a YouTube channel called, you know, Village Food Factory. Okay? They have created a video of preparing omelette. Preparing an omelette with a single egg is not a big deal. But this gentleman prepares with 1,000 eggs. He puts 1,000 eggs and he creates. Now this becomes massive. Wow. 1,000 eggs compared to whether to prepare omelette. My God, mind blowing. Now, people, when they are amazed, when you make people say, wow, this is amazing, you are done. You are done. This is business. You create content exclusively for your visitors, exclusively for your audience. Irrespective of its demand, competition, that, this and all. Exclusively create content for your audience alone. You will be having a massive reach. Wonderful. Okay, because I have experienced this one with lots of dentists, okay, where I have trained people and all. Content is the king. Content is the king. Unique content. Okay, no copy paste. Okay, unique content. So unique content is the king. Okay, now you can create content by just looking for a word inside online. We can call this one as a long tail keyword. That's what we do. Okay, so a process of keyword. Okay, we can go ahead. If you take a keyword, okay, we can have a keyword as like a one word keyword, where you use a single word to search, that is called one word keyword. Where you have a two word to search, chicken masala, this is a two word keyword. Okay, the same keyword, fried chicken masala, so this becomes a three word keyword. Okay, so this becomes a three word keyword, and there is something called LTK, that's basically a long tail keyword. Okay, this is basically called LTK, long tail keyword. Now, if you are already researching about digital SEO, all the stuff, you could have come across all this content and platforms. Okay.
Keywords. Yes. So your screen is not visible. Yeah. I don't know whether it is sharing or not.
No, actually, my screen is visible. Okay, sir, if there is anyone, oh, just a minute, I am presenting, it is giving me a confirmation. Okay, so my screen is visible, sir. Visible. If anyone who feels the screen is not visible, you simply disconnect and click the link and connect again, it will come. Okay, might be some technical issue, it will not show up, but my screen is visible from my side. Okay, but if anyone who is like not able to see, disconnect the call, come back again. Otherwise, pin on my ID and, you know, save it. Okay, that's two options you can have. Cool. So a keyword can be a one word keyword, two word keyword, three word keyword, and a long tail keyword. Okay. It is always a brilliant idea to choose a long tail keyword, a keyword which is very longer. Okay. Long. Reason, because you can convince a person only when he has a problem. You cannot convince a person who is already satisfied. You can only convince someone only when he has a problem. Okay. Now, when will people come and search online? When there is a need. When there will be a need? When there is a problem. When somebody, his mobile phone is not working, you know, battery is not working, the water purifier machine is not working. Now, they want to go search online, like, okay, water purifier repair shop, you know, battery, mobile, smartphone repair shop. Now, how will they search? Do you think they will search with a single keyword? Okay, water purifier? No. People will go online and they will start searching for water purifier technician. You agree my point? Water purifier technician in Chennai. If they are staying in Chennai. Water purifier technician in Theni. If they are staying in Theni. Water purifying technician nearby or in exactly Coimbatore. You are getting your point? Now, this is how people will search. Now, you are offering a service. You are a water purifier technician. What you can do? Water purifier technician in your location. Let me say I live in a district called Theni. Now, here. So, because of the COVID problem, it has been 4 months now. I am staying here. Now, water purifier technician in, I can say Theni, but what is my strategy? I will start writing content about every village in Theni. I start talking about Kodangapatti, I start talking about Vadinakanur, Allinagram, whatever it is, whichever I have it here, I start creating content about it. Okay, this is what Jasdale does. This is what Sulaika does. How many of you are aware of it? Correct? You go search about anything, man. Come on. You go search for 2 BHK flat in, let me say, in my native place, Theni. I hit enter. I still see my 99acres.com and other people coming at the top. Magic Bricks, 99acres.com, housing.com is coming at the top. Right? Now, do you think like only metropolitan cities they will be targeting? They have information for everything. 2 BHK flat in Theni. When I search for 2 BHK flat for rent in any of the remote village, okay, I can go to a very remote village. They still have a content under, you know, housing.com, 99acres.com, and they have content like anything. You create a mass content, unique quality content, you can simply drive people. Now, 99acres.com does not want to spend money on advertisement for targeting people from Theni because they are ranking little tougher. Okay, so we can use online to search some information and product or services to that one. Okay, so the more shorter your keyword is, like, you know, more, you know, wide range it is. When I say animals, now the next question is like, which animal you are referring to? I'll say wild animals. Now, in wild animals, which you are referring to? Maybe a lion. Okay, in lion, which you are referring to? Are you referring to a, you know, a cub, which is very small, something like that? Now, until I'm very specific, Google cannot give me my specific information, right? Now, I can use Google's auto suggest feature to understand the content related to my audiences in my business. Let me say your college is offering an MBA course. Let me say your college is offering a, you know, catering course, okay, or, you know, hotel management course, something like that. And if your website does not have a hotel management content, how can you expect people to come to your website when they search for hotel management services or courses in your area? The primary thing which I allow the most, because when people raise a question, I would like to answer about all those. Okay. And the topic which I initially had, one is that is related to when we, there is a COVID problem happening, when there is, like, you know, doctors and other people are busy doing their contribution, other stuff. So we are completely discussing about technical. Okay, that's really a great concern. A great salute to those people who are putting their heart and soul, not even heart and soul, they are putting their family responsibility inside the current situation. And right now, we are really blessed to thank the technology service provider, Google, and the internet service provider, people who are making it possible for us to connect like this. Number one, apart from the doctors and other people who are taking up servicing, you know, fighting in this industry, We are even supporting them by connecting virtually, not even contributing to a 0.5% of the probability of distributing the disease or the virus. Okay. We truly respect them. You know, they are our great resources. Okay. When we learn how to go digital in this particular platform, if you found we are completely technical in this one or not related to that one, okay, I will try to include examples related to this COVID and other situational scenarios, and I will be supporting with me hashtag and stay home hashtag too. We will be having it as a practice to move on. YouTube has launched its method to support people, express our support by adding hash with me in your YouTube title and also stay home in your YouTube title. So like this, we can also contribute to that one. Thank you so much for bringing it up. Upcoming examples and other stuff will be related to that one. Okay, number one. And the next thing related to the live organic results of inbound marketing techniques. Okay. Inbound marketing techniques. You need to have a live example of inbound marketing technique. Actually, I tried to show that on my screen. I think we missed it. If you have missed it, okay, I'll tell you right now. Okay, so what is inbound marketing? Is basically making people to come to you. Okay, making people to come to you indirectly. Inbound means incoming. People coming from other sources to our site. So incoming. So what happens is, like, we will try to distribute our content across the globe. And when people looks our content, they will come to us. You will come in search of me. You are getting my point? Okay, one example of inbound marketing is SEO, search engine optimization practice. Okay, creating a content and all other stuff. For example, you create an infographic and post it into social media. Now, when people look at the social media, they will connect with you in turn. Okay. So indirectly, people will come in search of you instead of you going in search of people. You are getting my point? People will come in search of you instead of you going in search of those people. Okay, so I can add or I can increase my content in my website in such a way that people are looking for, where people can gain attention coming to my website, and I can convert them into my business, either by showing up a pop-up window, either by showing up, you know, screen and all of that stuff. Okay, I can do that. So this is how. Yeah. Now, what is one more questions? If you want, you can raise it. I can just answer that. Gentlemen, is there any other questions? If you have, do let me know. Okay. Thank you, Renu, for raising this question and these options. Okay. How to start digital marketing in initial stage of marketing? How to collect data to publish? Okay, Mr. Vishwanathan, you don't need to collect data to publish your content. Okay, if you are following optimization technique on social media and SEO, please be consistent in creating your information and sharing to the world. I mean, to the world, continuously. Create, share, create, share, create, share. Do your task. When people explore your content, they will come and connect with you. They will come and connect with you. You don't need to have a database ready to start digital marketing. You can collect database. Okay, once you are running an advertisement campaign, okay, you can make people to register their first name, last name, email address, other details, and later you can use it to publish your content. Okay, you keep publishing your content on your website again and again continuously, your content database will increase, the probability of your visibility will be very high. Once your content is visible, obviously you can connect with people, and that's what it happens. Okay, so we don't need to have a database ready to happen. Okay, let me say you are a person who want to reach maximum people with a particular topic. Okay, choose YouTube, because YouTube is a place where people are keep searching for what they want. Okay, YouTube is a place where people are keep looking and searching for what they want to learn, what they want to get, and all this stuff. Now go to YouTube, create one video every day, keep continuously updating about your business and other stuff that helps your audiences to understand more. Now they will come to you. And another inbound marketing technique. You get my point? Okay, if you are choosing YouTube, that's great. If you are going to Instagram, stick on to Instagram. Make sure that you hit Instagram harder and drive more visitors from Instagram. You get my point? You drive more visitors from Instagram. Finish off Instagram. Make yourself branded, visible in Instagram. Then go to Facebook. Now go to Facebook and hit it hard in Facebook. then you can also have it really great. Okay, so you don't need to wait for anything. Action is the only thing which is missing in lots of people in digital. They don't act. Okay, that's one thing. Okay, I'm just exploring. Is there any other questions? Okay. Okay. Any other questions, gentlemen? Please raise it. Okay, I am planning to buy a domain and a hosting to initiate my DM for myself. So you give me some tips, help while buying a domain or hosting. Okay, it is free or paid, because lots of stuffs are out in the marketing which is confusing me. That is true, Kritika. Okay, so that is really true. If you want to do something on your own in digital industry, better start your free blog using blogger.com. Okay, start your free blog using blogger.com, and to start with, to practically implement and all this stuff, you have unlimited access to it. You are not limited to anything in trying out something new. Okay, I really appreciate doing that, because you know very well, laddu laddu kaiya vechittu vaayila pesna inikkadu andha latta kadichadha inikkum, right? The biggest problem here is, like, we preach people without, you know, experiencing it. It's the biggest problem we have, right? You know, something is sweet only when you eat it, right? So the thing is, like, once you want to establish yourself in digital, the first strategy that you can do for those common people whomsoever here who is not associated with any organization or something like that, you want to go digital online, better start a website or a blog in your name. In your name. Out of your own interest, which you like the most. Right? Anything. Start from that. Start implementing content writing. Start implementing SEO practices. Start running advertisement for your campaign by yourself. Start running a social media advertisement. Okay, start running your email advertisement, all of this stuff. Okay, do it by yourself. You are done. If you go to an organization to experience all those, they will hire you as a SEO executive. They will tell you to do only SEO activity. Okay, you will not get opportunity to work on advertisement campaigns. Correct? And you go to an email marketing executive, you will become only email marketing executive. You won't get opportunity to get hands on your SEO content. Now my suggestion is, create your own website on your own content using any platform or a free platform. You can even go for self-hosted paid platforms, approximately to get a quality service with the self-hosted paid programs. 10,000 rupees per annum is a feasible process. 10,000 rupees per annum is a feasible process that you can have it per year, then you can use it. But I tell you, digital marketing information, knowledge is available for free. If you are a self learner, pull up your socks, discipline yourself, start reading about it. It took just 10 years for me to get out those, to become a professional in this. Okay, from 2005 to 2015. Okay, 2016 was a takeoff to become a professional in the industry. Okay, and it all happened because of one reason, of practicing. Look at this one. Okay, EDU, 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 India. This is the first blog which I created in, I think, around 2005. But in 2008 only, I published my first content. Look at this one. You personally ask me, this is the photo which I uploaded. This is my profile which I have. You're getting a point? Knowing nothing about it. What it is, I don't know. Then, when I was a little bit knowledgeable, I started something on my own. AmadanRaju.blogspot.com. Again, another free platform. Okay? I was working in a company full time. I was doing in my free time. I was actually exploring all the content, all this stuff here. Okay. Then once I started knowing about SEO concepts, I started writing a blog, a technical blog like this, appnow.com, where I create, write content regular basis. And when people look at my content, I display advertisement in this one. Google pays for every click which I receive, and I take money through appnow.com. Once I become knowledgeable in the industry, I got an opportunity to train people, and that is how I started creating my website, amadkumar.com. Now this transformation is almost a 10-year transformation. You're getting a point, right? Full and full self-learning and everything. Okay. Now, if you are a self-learner, learn by yourself. Otherwise, please hire a trainer, personal trainer for you. Okay, that is your choice. Okay. Now, so from this one to this one is full of trial and error method. The design which I have created, the content which I have, the image which I have, everything is created by me, for me. I am not dependent on any technical person. You are getting a point? Okay, so this website gives me a revenue. This website gives me leads for my training businesses. And this is where I started. Okay, now, so this is the transformation from here to till this one. Yeah, this transformation should happen with everybody whomsoever is here. Whomever is the person over here, this transformation should happen with everybody. You should start somewhere and you should go, you should experience it by yourself, then only you will understand about it. That is purely your choice. Okay. Free access SEO websites ask for domains. I have tried earlier to write blogs, so please guide me which platform we can get for free. Okay, in my personal experience, for free hosting, I always suggest blogger.com only. For free hosting, I always suggest blogger.com only. Blogger.com is a Google's own product, so never ever go anywhere. Go to blogger.com and give it a try. Okay. If anyone is not knowing to create a content, is there any agency available to do? Yes, Renuka, there is always an agency to do it. But remember, anything that you don't know is always an expense. You are getting my point? Anything you don't know about something is always an expense. Better learn it. A skill you own is the revenue that you need. Okay? Okay.
But I want to know that whether it should be standard ones, be easily accessible, so many things. Make a consultation with the agency, is it fine? That's what I'm asking.
That's okay. If you're willing to spend.
But I'm not sure about that.
See, in any industry, even you take Sachin Tendulkar, Sachin Tendulkar is one of the greatest players in cricket, correct? But he never plays without a mentor, without his coach, right? So, in any industry you take, if you have somebody as your consultant with you, that is really a good choice. Okay, hire the right person, simple thing. Okay, you tend to save time and money. You tend to save time and money when you have somebody who is knowledgeable in the industry. Okay, I want to create my own website in Google for free, of course. Is it possible? If yes, what is the procedure? Okay, this is a very long type of question, Miss Annie. Okay, now I can give you an answer for this, but anyway, I'll take some time. Okay. Is there any other question? Okay, so I want to create my website for free on Google. Okay. Google. Okay. Anyway, I tell you, gentlemen, I want to give it in your hands. In the initial days, I was keep talking about this website, amadukumar.com, correct? My guess is, how much do you think that I have spent to create this website? Anybody from the team? How much do you think that I have spent from this, for creating this website? Any guess? How much will be the money that I have spent to create a content and host it and maintain it for this website? Any answer? Because there is a lot of questions related to free hosting, creating, maintaining, SEO, something like that. Okay. Oh.
Nothing. You told that it is a self-learning exercise.
Okay.
Right. Based on that, maybe minimum 5,000 rupees.
Oh, okay. 5,000 rupees what I have sent.
Based on your learning, I'm telling, but normally it will cost around 30,000 minimum to create a website. That's true.
Okay.
With minimum domains.
Okay. So it depends on the business goal also. Let me say, if I want to create something like Amazon, I have to spend crores and crores, to be very frank. Okay. Now, anyway, so for domain name and hosting, I guess 5 days.
For the entire thing you are telling, for your own website creation is there, no, sir? Basically, for a student or for an individual.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And normally, what does it cost, sir?
Normally, when you go for a WordPress website with the dynamic content, all the stuff, okay, as I already said, 10,000 rupees per year is feasible. 10,000 per year. Okay, because you go with 1,000 rupees per month approximately, 10,000 when I say 800-900 rupees approximately. Okay, but this is purely your choice. Okay, now what happens is, like, there are three platforms like blogger.com, wordpress.com and all of this stuff. Okay, now people said like 5,000, 10,000 is what I spent to create the website which I have right now. Right. Mr. Praveen Prasad says no money, zero. Okay. I think they are kidding me. Okay. Anyway, gentlemen, if I say the price which I'm using, which I'm spending.
Without the money, at least basic money, which is meaningless, nobody will respect us. For example, for your information, sir, we advertised it is free program. Mm-hmm. But yesterday we got a message out of 7 groups, one group, one person created. Oh, so many scenes and drama is going on. For sharing this link and all, we know what are all the technical issues. So okay. We are doing, being an academic institution which is totally free, and we are working down to earth, that you know, and you are also part of it. And apart from that, one assistant professor raised the question that whether by using our mail ID, is it a profit motive like that?
Okay.
So we have n number of email IDs.
Mm-hmm.
There is no profit motive, only for sharing the knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
And enriching the students only we are doing conducting programs.
True, I understand.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I really appreciate the...
Sir, Ramadhan, what is the tomorrow's session, and they will be eagerly waiting, and tomorrow they should join by 11:30.
Okay.
Kindly share the tomorrow's plan and...
I think Mr. Nirmal has shared with me, I think the same schedule is what we will go with it. Okay.
Okay.
So I think now we have a CEO. It is a social media marketing topic in the morning session and mobile marketing topic in the evening session. Okay. So we will manage to
tomorrow, have both. We are also eagerly waiting along with this Google Meet participant as well as live YouTube participants.
Okay.
And kindly check the groups then and there. We will put the messages for joining this group.
Okay.
Okay, by using the same link you can do, or otherwise we will update you. No issue at all.
Thank you so much.
Feel free to contact us anytime, any moment. We sure. are here to serve all the students community. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Okay.
Thank
now,
you.
Gentlemen, for the question which you have raised for the amount of money spent for creating this blog, which I have. Okay. It is 860 rupees plus GST. Okay.
My God.
Okay.
So, which is a motivation for the students to have their own.
Of course.
Platform.
Of course.
Mm, yeah.
860 rupees plus GST. See, I have used the options whichever is available to use it as a best, because you know very well in the starting itself I said I was exploring opportunity where I do not want to invest money but I want to make more money. Okay. 860 rupees per year plus GST, that is only for my domain name registration, that too with Google. You are getting my point? Okay, that too with Google. Okay, how many of you say Google is a good company? Can you just send me a text message? Okay, Google is a good company or not? Is it good? Is the standard okay? Right? Yes or no? Yes, it is. Now, when people say I'm hosting with AWS, Amazon Web Services, okay? Now what happens? They make huge money, obviously. Amazon Web Services is costly, to be very frank. Now, what I do? I host with Google. Okay, I host my website with Google. And what happens here? Let me see the data, how it is coming. Why it's not showing? Okay, amadukumar.com. Take some time, sorry. Okay. Can you see who is hosting me? Google is hosting me. Okay, I'm hosting with Google, and the amount of money that I spend is 860 rupees per year. And for your information, okay, I'm not sure whether I can reveal it or not. I'm training people and the course fees and all the stuff. And you know very well, okay, I literally do not want to reveal that here. Okay. Now it is possible, it is feasible. I already told you, you don't need to be a millionaire, multi-millionaire to start in digital. It is affordable. Okay, how to do it, how to take it forward and everything, that is the in-depth topics and other details. Okay,
that is,
that's one thing.
Okay.
Okay, so we have Ranganathan KSG Institution Coimbatore. Okay, we have a lot of questions. Gentlemen, is there any other questions? If you have, you can raise it. Okay. If you feel you the amount of discussion which we
yes,
had
sir, tomorrow also we will continue, sir. No issue. They will feel free to contact us.
We will contact
sir, us. I have one.
Anyway.
Yeah, basically we have to create some short our website in our name, and we put some links on that on the YouTube.
Yes,
so
sir.
That any customer then go for that website, they click the link and they find our products and briefing and technical specification, which is audio visual. This type of a concept is also running right now.
This is the best method to do it, sir. we are going to attract people to our website. This is what it is, the ultimate goal. I tell people, writing content is like putting that particular, you know, insect on the, you know, fish handle, you know, right? So mantra rules are wrong, right?
Yeah, myself Praveen Prasad. So I sent that zero at that time, because there is a requirement, because lot of cloud system is there which is offering that free of cost, but the joining fee is free, and after 1 year they charge some money. When your website runs good, then they charge the money. Number of people when attempt that website, then we pay the money for them.
That's really a good observation, Mr. Praveen. See, I want to tell you one thing for the complete crowd. Remember, the costliest word in the market is free. I tell you, the costliest word in the market is free. The word free is $1 million business. If you don't know about it, know it today. The word free, right, is $1 million business. Okay, you know what happens? Okay, Google, $385 billion company. Facebook, $38 billion company. Now you take Facebook is free, Twitter is free, Instagram is free, LinkedIn is free, TikTok is free, YouTube is free. You are getting the point, right? The Google Meet application you are using right now, it is free. Now free. But all these companies are worth $1 million. You're getting a point. Now you should learn the art of how to use free to market your business. Okay. So it's almost going to be 4 now. Okay. It's really great. Thank you so much for connecting for today's session. Okay. Thank you so much, gentlemen. We will again connect tomorrow at 11:30, as madam has said. Okay. Take care. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir. Take care.
Thank you.